Welcome to Ethanol Producer Magazine's top headlines from the past week. I'm your host, Jill Nelson. Mark your calendar now for the 36th Annual International Fuel Ethanol Workshop and Expo, taking place in Minneapolis, Minnesota, June 15th through the 17th, 2020. The FEW is the world's largest ethanol event and is truly where producers meet. Visit fuelethanolworkshop.com to learn more. Iowa Representative Axne sent a letter to U.S. EPA Acting Inspector General Charles Sheehan August 21st, requesting the EPA Office of the Inspector General conduct an investigation into the agency's questionable decision-making and misuse of its Small Refinery Exemption, or SRE, authority to benefit large or unqualified companies that may be exerting an undue amount of influence over the regulatory process. Axne made the announcement that she was seeking the investigation during an August 21st event at Southwest Iowa Renewable Energy in Council Bluffs, Iowa. During her event at SIRE, Axne criticized the Trump administration for its treatment of SREs and the agriculture community. The Renewable Fuels Association and Growth Energy have spoken out to slam the U.S. EPA's August 20th claim that there is a zero evidence of demand destruction for ethanol associated with the agency's treatment of small refinery exemptions, or SREs. Reuters published an article August 20th quoting an EPA spokesman as saying in an emailed statement, "There is zero evidence that EPA's congressionally mandated small refinery exemption program has had any negative effect on domestic corn ethanol producers." RFA President and CEO Jeff Cooper said to suggest that there is zero evidence of ethanol and corn demand destruction from small refinery waivers is as insulting as it is absurd, noting that at least 15 ethanol plants have shut down or idled since the EPA began its refinery bailout bonanza last year. Growth Energy CEO Emily Skor said the SREs are having a devastating impact on farm communities and rural workers in America's biofuel sector, noting that dozens of biofuel plants have cut production and ethanol consumption fell for the first time in 20 years last year. The U.S. EPA posted a notice to its website August 21st extending the public comment period on its review of the renewable fuel standard under Section 610 of the Regulatory Flexibility Act through September 23rd. Section 610 of the Regulatory Flexibility Act requires an agency to review, within 10 years of promulgation, each rule that has or will have a significant economic impact of a substantial number of small entities. Learn more in our online coverage. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back next week with more of the ethanol industry's top stories.